Hallo.
Hallo. Hola, hola.
Hola, hola. ¿No? ¿No?
Uno, dos.
Hallo. Hallo.
Hola. ¿Hay alguien que nos ayude?
Hallo. Hallo.
Hallo.
Hola,
Yes.
hola.
Ja,
Sí,
danke. Ja.
okay.
So herzlich willkommen. Welcome home, actually, to Camilo, Diana, and Jung, alumni from KHM, and you know the place better than me. So I'll give mic to Tanya, and she can continue.
Hi, good night, welcome everyone. Camilo, Diana, and Jung, very welcome.
Hello.
I will read a small presentation.
Okay.
Vamos Animation is an independent animation studio based in Cologne, a collective of artists who studied at the Academy of Media Arts Cologne with a focus on animation and founded their company Vamos. In 2028 with a grant from the Media Founders Center, NRB. Vamos has specialized in animation for short films, documentaries, installation, and in addition to classic animation, is particularly interested in new formats and fields of application in the field of animation such as augmented reality, virtual reality, and video mapping. The different nationalities and cultural backgrounds of the members of the collective enable them to offer a multicultural approach to their themes, projects with which they celebrate successes at international festivals and exhibitions. Very welcome.
Thank you. Dankeschön. Ich bin I'm Camilo. I'm from Colombia. I studied here at the KHM postgraduately. First, I studied at the university in Colombia. I studied at the film school, and then I came here to do my postgraduate studies. So I am going to present Diana and Jung, and the fourth member is not here, but we will see him shortly. It's Shin. We are all here from the KHM.
Hello. Sorry, my English not good at good enough to present here. And then, so kann ich auf Deutsch sprechen? Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Ja, ich bin jung und dann ja, ich bin auch ein Absolvent von KM und dann ja in Vamos normalerweise ich mache immer neue Sachen, zum Beispiel Video Mapping oder VR, AR, solche Sachen und dann auch in KM gerade unterrichte ich TV Paint oder After Effects, solche Animationssoftware. Dankeschön.
I'm Diana. I'm also from Colombia. And the first time I was at the KHM was with an exchange with the Universidad Nacional de Colombia. I came for 5 months and I stayed longer, almost 1 year. And then I did here my diploma for my fine arts studies in Colombia. And then I came back as a postgraduate student. I worked mostly at the KHM with installations, with animation, and with documentary. That was like the way I did.
Hello, everybody. Boa noite. Thanks for coming to see Vamos Works in KHM. I am Shin, one of animators in Vamos. So I have focused into the animation, motion graphics, and expanded animation in general. So I start my studies as a fine arts in Brazil. I work at also as a comic writer, illustrator, and I finished my studies in KHM 4 years ago, with focus in experimental animation. So since then I'm working with Vamos in several projects, experimental stuff. So I hope you enjoyed our animation. Have a good fun, and big hugs from Brazil. And yeah, ciao, ciao, ciao.
So Shin is actually in Sao Paulo. He's gonna be there for until January. No? We're gonna explain a little bit how what's going to happen today. I'm gonna present what we created, this animation studio, which is called Vamos Animation. We're gonna see some works, animated works, very like varied conceptions, and like short films, a little bit commercial stuff that we have done, more experimental stuff, mapping, etc. And at the end, we're gonna show you some augmented reality work we have done. And
it's actually very good that you are not so much, so many people. Because yeah,
and
we can have the space,
some video mapping also, like over there. For the augmented reality stuff, we have an iPad, but you can also download an app which is called Arti Vive, which is free. And if you download it, you can see the stuff on your handy, on your
it's
cell phone.
A VIP experience for the people that is here on the room.
Yes, because we're going to be streamed live. I think we are being streamed live, and sadly, for this streaming people, we cannot show this, the streaming public. So I'm going to present Vamos. We created the studio actually in 2016. This was a mistake. Yeah, I know. At the end of our studies here at KHM, usually the question is, okay, what now? So we came together and decided, okay, we're going to build something for ourselves, because I think there's not a super high and big animation industry in Germany, not as in France, for example. And so getting jobs is not that easy. And anyway, if you have your own thing, you are your own boss, which is also nice.
And if you are in a team, you are stronger.
Exactly, because you don't have to do like everything by yourself. We created the studio with a stipendium from the Mediengründerzentrum NRW, which is an institution that it's a seeding program for or an incubator, it's called, for small companies, for media companies in NRW. So it's a good way to start a company, because you get like seminars on, I don't know, taxes and the media environment in NRW, its TV channels, whatever. And you get also a little like funding for the first steps, paying an office, buying some equipment, paying for a website, etc. Exactly, and then we have been working together since 2016. Yeah, so also
actually a bit before, no? Because of course, here are some guys of the animation studio. You notice you are like an area of the KHM, and you live there, so you know each other very well, no? And you know how the others work, and that's why also
We actually came together because we were working together here at the KHM. What else? So, that's the thing. A little bit also the philosophy about from Vamos is to, okay, if you wanna go and outside the world and do your personal stuff, your personal works, films, it's not that easy. And if you were with other people, it's easier. The workload is less. there's feedback from other people, so you're not like in a cocoon. And having a company allows you to like get funding, and yeah, like have jobs and like projects. And in that like structure, you can then build your or do your own projects, your personal projects, which is also a thing we're gonna see today. We're gonna see a work by Diana at the end, which is her last short film. So yeah, let's start with our first.
Very first animation we made as animation studio.
Yeah, it's a short film. It's documentary. It is based on interviews made to some refugees that are by the time had arrived shortly in Germany, and we're living like the German first experience. And yeah, so that's what we're gonna see now.
Should we show the second one afterwards? And when?
Ah, yeah. Huh? Then.
So you will watch two movies at once, and then okay. I can say something about the okay. second one.
In unserer Land, bei den Bauern, da gibt so viele Tiere. Lamm und die anderen, die machen Mäh. Und alle Tiere mit Ränge am Bein oder Nase. So der Bauer weiß, der Gehut zu finden. In Deutschland, Leute haben Ränge am Nase oder Bauch. Und das ist sehr komisch noch für mich.
Hier, ich sehe Oma und Opa zusammen, halten an die Hände, die gehen auf Supermarkt, die eine schieben Wagen, die andere packen ein. Oder im Park, die gehen mit so Stocke da und das finde ich sehr schön. In meinem Land, Oma und Opa machen nur ba, 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 ba. Aber sie wollen nicht mal sitzen zusammen.
Manchmal mir nervt die Termine. Immer, man muss pünktlich da gehen und wenn wir gehen da, wir müssen noch mal warten. Die sagen, sie kommen sie bitte zum Beispiel um 11 Uhr oder 12 Uhr, aber wenn wir sind da nochmal, man muss warten ein oder zwei oder mehr Stunden. Und wenn wir haben Kind, wir können nicht so länger bleiben. Sie sind sehr streng. Und wenn die Kind weinen, sie sagen langsam, geh raus. Oder ja, geh raus.
Jeden Tag ich sehe die Männer und Frauen auf die Straße laufen, sprechen zusammen und für mich das ist nicht so schön. Wenn die küssen sich auf die Straße und schämen sich nicht. Bei uns das ist, wir dürfen sowas nicht machen.
You said you don't like the refugee people, but I don't think that. Our country, when we see the blonde woman, a beauty, and she married a black man, we say, ah, she's a beauty. How she married that man? Now, I'm thinking that always. Here, the blonde woman, they marry a black man, and they have Kinder. And the baby is black too.
Sometimes when I go to a supermarket and I wait the food, or my children give something special, then I go ask how much. And they say, yeah, it's no expensive. Then I go cashier and the bill come and I think, what? But then shame and I buy.
The Germans, they're more positive. Some of them I see, they even smile on the street.
Yeah, that was just a chapter of
the last one.
Of yeah, the last chapter of three of this film, and I think with these two films we learn about how to work together. No, but because yeah, we work together, but helping the others at the KHM. But here it was like, okay, we have to have like our own product. No. So I think when I watch this, I will do a lot of things very different now, because these are now a bit old. But yeah, that were our first experiences as working in the same movie. Now, and yeah, my Allerliebstes Lieblingsding was a project from the Goethe Institute that was part of a much bigger project called
Missing Movies,
and from a long episode film called Borderless Stories of Friendship and
I forgot
something like that, but it's like 1 hour film that they wanted to do once again for refugees, and that's why you don't hear anything about the characters.
And these were like sort of commission films or like film funded films in the sense of like you go with a project and you ask for funding.
The or first like one, Black, Red, Yellow, Schwarz, Rot, Gelb, it was funded by the Filmstiftung NRW. For short film, the director, she already had made the interviews, mm-hmm. and she had this idea for a long time, but hadn't like get too started. And then we applied here at the NAVE, and we got the money, and then we started the production. The second one, as Diana told you before, it was this missing movies project by the Goethe Institute. They made an open call, we presented ourselves, and then we went to Jordan, to Amman, and there was a workshop there, because in Jordan there's like one of the biggest refugee camps in the Middle East, and at the end of the workshop it resulted they wanted to produce several short films for so that they could have like a bag, like a suitcase of films to show in the camps for mm-hmm. kids. So that's why they don't have like a voice, because it has to be neutral. Mm-hmm. And then it became bigger because in Germany they cannot fund like several short films at the same time. So the production company, they called in a production company, and the Goethe Institute had like an initial money. The production company then got the WDR, the TV channel, and funding from the Filmstiftung NRW, and they packed like the short films into a feature film. And this feature film had like several chapters, and we had our movie, which has like three segments, three episodes, like also inside this film. And yeah, so that project exists as a short film and as a each short film, and then as a packaged feature film.
And about your question, if that was an idea of us, no? At that time we were working also with a ex-KHM guy that was having new babies. And we were also thinking, okay, he had a baby and a girl that was 4 or 5 years old, and he was like, we have to do something for kids. So we were also very attracted by the idea, and we were just like trying to develop some ideas for doing something for kids, and that was like the best opportunity of this missing movies project, no? Because we were like we were thinking to do something, so here we are, and that's what.
And so you also like collaborate with like other people, right? Because it's like you can read in the like credits.
Yeah.
That sometimes, I mean, they are like always you, but then there are like other people with whom you collaborate, right?
Yeah. For some projects, we brought also people from KHM or people that wanted to study at the KHM, or friends. No, I mean, like the people you work afterwards is like the people you study with. So yeah, that's your team.
And even in the last one, these two, this is like a documentary segment because this is based on documentary stuff. The first one in like audio recordings. And the second one, the children that appear are real children that we found doing like drawing workshops. And then through these workshops, they would tell us stories. And then, yeah, it was a long process, and this girl told us about being in Syria and fleeing and what happened to her house. And but we also, in the other two chapters we have there, one is a girl in Colombia and the other is a young boy here in Cologne. So the other two chapters, we did workshops in Colombia and we did a workshop here three workshops here in Germany. Yeah. So now we're gonna watch some more.
Do you want to say something about what is coming?
We're gonna see like some stuff, like two clips that are based on, this is more commercial stuff, like commission stuff. But in a kind very open, because they're quite like experimental and weird. Thank you. Examples of commercial work we have done. The first one, it's quite weird because this Urbanana Awards, these awards are given by Tourismus NRW, and they give every year, every 2 years, like an award to great ideas for tourism in North Rhine-Westphalia. So they approached us and told us, hey, we want to give, instead of like an, I don't know, like some metal stuff, statue to the winners, we want to give each project in, the winner of each project in each category, like a small animation that they can then use in their webpage or whatever. So it was this kind of tailor-made short animations that were given as an award. It was also interesting because there were like six or seven categories I had that won a prize. And we had like to do it quite fast. We then decided to divide the different shorts, short animated films. So like each of us took like two or one of the animation studio and developed it like on his pathway. The second one is for the Videonale, which is video art and media arts based festival here in Bonn. And the first one is super short and without sound because this was thought for the U-Bahn stations as a like a loop for when you're waiting for the U-Bahn that you see the informations and then okay, this is gonna be in 2 weeks, next week or whatever. And the second one was the screener for their films that were shown then in the in Bonn in the museum where the Biennale was. They are both like quite experimental in their approach, and also like a contact through QHM because the person who was doing like the whole graphic design for the Biennale is a former QV of QHM. His name is Oliver Ascioli, and he was here before doing like printing stuff and like design stuff here at QHM. Exactly. So,
in the sound, I would like to know about the sound design.
I made the sound design.
Huh?
I made the sound design.
You made the sound design. Beautiful. Yeah, great.
Thank you. yeah. I usually when it's like small stuff inside the studio, I do the sound design. Diana and you and Shin, they do like concept character development and line development, and Jung, as he told us, he does like a lot of the VR, augmented reality, like new technologies. And I also produce most of the thing inside the studio. So we have found like a way of working together in which we have like each one has like a an area of expertise, and then and all of us for then direct if there's like the need for direction, like doing Regie. Yeah.
Und ich finde, das ist echt interessant, diese videonale Animation mit dem Papier haben wir gemacht, aber eigentlich wir haben viel irgendwie viele Verbindung mit KM, und dann seit 2018 ich habe hier Augmented Reality Workshop gemacht, aber Augmented Reality, aber den Inhalt haben wir richtig viel mit dem analogischen Sachen zusammen gemacht, und ja, da, das war der erste Workshop, und dann ich habe einfach verschiedene farbige Papier zu Studenten gegeben, und dann die haben irgendwie ähnlich wie diese videonale Animation gemacht, und dann davon habe ich Inspiration bekommen, und dann später für diese Werbung habe ich die eine Direktorin gemacht.
So the next one, short introduction, it's longer. It's a short film by Shin. More afterwards, because this short is then a bridge to these other things that are like more experimental and spatial and like not classical. Thank you.
sempre quis saber de onde vêm os sonhos. Sei lá, depende do tamanho. Talvez o menorzinho cresça dentro da fruta e a gente tenha que colher do pé. Então, quem come sanduíche, um bom sonhador não é. E tem aqueles que a gente aprende na escola ou compra na loja. Tem também os que vêm voando e aqueles que a gente cata do chão. Tem sonho de todo jeito. No final, pouco importa de onde vem ou de que tipo são. Mas para onde eles vão? Quando era jovem, digo, mais jovem, que velho não sou muito. Quinta era o dia de afinar no bar. A gente tinha em mente viajar o país inteiro. E começamos a compor os maiores clássicos do futuro. Precisei construir uma casa para três. Aí parecia que uma hora eram duas. E quanto tempo eu levaria até a aposentadoria? Saindo do escritório, eu iria conquistar o mundo. Quem sabe, um dia. O quintal que a gente brincava era maior do que o pátio da escola. Foi ali que nós montamos uma sociedade secreta, com estratégia para firmar a sede na ilha de Madagascar. No nunca chegamos lá, mas expandimos fronteira pelo vasto território do vizinho e construímos um esconderijo subterrâneo invisível que dava no Oceano Pacífico. Faltamos na aula durante 1 milhão de anos. No final, nossa quarta série durou o dobro de 1 ano. A minha pequenininha era mais chegada a mim do que a mãe. Eu era o amigão, que chegava em casa de costas dobradas depois do trabalho. Aí minha menina queria andar de cavalo. Como um cavalo, o tempo corria rápido ao quadrado. Tão rápido ela cresceu. Pena eu não ter ficado para assistir. Saí buscar tudo que eu perdi um dia, ou deixei cair daqui de dentro. Estudei, trabalhei, viajei, não achei. Peguei um ou outro pedacinho que preste, um caco de um sonho quebrado, e talvez uma criatura para estar sempre comigo. Enquanto eu ando para frente, na vida que é só caminho de ida, porque se nela não há caminho de volta, que pena, então não há mais volta. Thank you.
this well, this short film has a little bit like a long story. Shin started with this project at the KHM, and then it became bigger, and he shot in like in several places. This is shot in Sao Paulo, in Bogota, I believe he also
in Zagreb,
in Rostov,
in Japan, or
yes, in Tokyo, and well, in Yokohama, I think. So he shot a lot of stuff, and then he sat down and like, okay, what is working, what is not working, and yeah.
But he had like the voiceover from the beginning, or he was just like doing it?
He had a story, he wrote a text with a friend, with this girl, Voss, with Sylvia Voss. And yeah, so they developed the text, and then he started like doing this animations, and but he would like project night and he would go out at night and start projecting stuff on the street and taking pictures of it. And so it's a, like a long process. And sometimes he would shoot things and then would see it the other day and would like wouldn't work like really good. And yeah, so he every time he had a trip, he would like shoot in that place where he was. And yeah, you wanted to.
Ja, das ist eine Erinnerung. Und dann, ja, ich erinnere mich an erste Versuch von Shin mit dem Mobile Projection. Und dann, ja, damals, ja, wir waren noch Student KM und dann vor dem Animationsstudio. Ich habe gelaubt und dann Shin ist gekommen und dann mir ein Referenzvideo gezeigt. Damals die Animationsstudio, jetzt nicht mehr, aber da gibt es nur oder meistens analog oder irgendwie Animation nur für Leinwand, für Premiere oder Festival. Und dann ganz selten so ein mit dem Beamer oder mit dem AR, VR Sachen. Und dann Shin ist echt ein interessanter Mann, er liebt richtig analogische Sachen und dann er macht weiter immer auf dem Papier viel. Und dann damals war er noch irgendwie altmodisch, aber plötzlich hat er ein Video mit dem Mobile Beamer gezeigt und dann ich dachte, und dann Unsinn. Und ich habe das ignoriert, aber nach einem Monat hat er eine Animation mit dem Beamer gezeigt und dann mich gefragt, ob ich mit dem Kamera diese Animation ja, fotografieren kann. Und dann, das war Anfang von dieser Mobile Projection. Und dann, was cool ist, damit haben wir mit dem Beamer befreundet. Und dann, danach, deswegen, ich finde, können wir weiter mit dem Videomapping oder andere Konzerte mit dem Videokunst schaffen. Ja, danke.
So now crossing from this projection stuff, which we did, we started like doing mobile projection stuff at the KHM, coming from like three seminars that were given by QVs here. So that thing, this going out and project outside, started with that. And this thing now, what we're I'm going to show you now is mapping project with it for an organization in France. I'll tell you a little bit about later. This is a documentation of that mapping.
Hello.
this 2021, last year, no? There's this organization in the north of France, it's called Audiovisual Meetings, Rencontres Audiovisuels, in French. And they have built like the center for doing video mapping in Lille and around the region, of the northern region of France. They do this kind of stuff regularly. They have also a festival in, I think, at the end of the winter, the beginning of spring, each year. They also have a like an awards, and they trying to make this video mapping scene much bigger. You saw it's based on patterns. These patterns are from a indigenous group of Panama and Colombia, which are called, now I forgot them. The Kunas, exactly. And we based the whole video mapping on these patterns. Here again, we worked with, we had some collaborators, a friend from Brazil, from Shin, and like Sebastian Gimmel, which is, he studied with us here at KHN. So again, there comes this friends who are like around us also like to collaborate. Questions? So the next thing. So this is a part of a documentation of multimedia concert with it we did in October. Thank you. was actually a concert that had several pieces and was about 1 hour long. We did this at the Alte Feuerwache in the north part of here in Cologne, in was this the Snippes? No, Agnesviertel. Yeah. Jung, want to tell us something?
Ah, okay. Und ja, das ist unsere erste Konzert mit dem Videokunst. Und dann damals wollten wir eigentlich an dem Wand von dem Alte Feuerwache Videomapping machen. Aber ja, wegen Noise und Beschwerung von dem Nachbarn konnten wir das nicht schaffen. Und dann, ja, die Chefin, die Organisatorin sagte, ja, ihr könntet diesen Raum haben. Und dann, ja, wir sind eigentlich experimentalische Animationsstudio, nicht nur medienmäßig, sondern auch haltungsmäßig. Okay, dann probieren wir ein Konzert mit unserer Arbeit. Da gibt es auch neue Arbeit, aber da gibt es auch unsere alte Arbeit. Und dann, wir haben das wieder benutzt mit dem Live-Musik. Und dann, da gibt es, was cool ist, nach dem KM, neben uns gibt es viele Künstler, die Video machen könnten. Und dann diese interaktive Sachen, Shin gemacht, Camillo hat das gemacht. Und dann ich habe mit dem Leute ein Musikvideo gedreht und dann einen Pianisten habe ich zu Hause. Und dann, ja, mit dem, ja, habe ich,
okay. The piano player is her girlfriend.
Ja, ja, meine Freundin, Pianistin. Und dann damit haben wir ein stündiges Konzert geplant. Und dann, das war nicht perfekt, aber ich finde, das war irgendwie echt ein cooler Versuch. Und dann, ja, das war das. Dankeschön.
So, this is the last film we're going to show. This is Diana's new film. Enjoy. Yeah, yeah, you want to say something?
I have to say something and I forgot. Yeah, it can't be streamed now because it's still running in festivals. So just for you here at in this room. And yeah, if you have questions, then you can ask whatever you want afterwards.
short film by Diana. Please ask her.
Yeah, if you have questions as well. I don't know how are we at the time, because
okay,
no worries. Yeah.
So tell us just a bit, how you developed the idea. What was a little bit part of the process? Yeah.
Yeah. The idea came after my fine art studies. I worked with a friend with whom I studied also, and we were like after fine art studies, like, and now. Once again, and then we just wanted to do something, and we were very inspired by haikus, and we just began to read a lot of haikus and draw, and then we had like lots of drawings that didn't have a connection, and then we said like, this should be a story, but don't know how, and and then slowly we noticed that we were having like a character in each of these drawings, and then we connect just ideas, and it developed like that. It was like not from the beginning very thought. I mean, like it was like very intuitive, no? Yeah, we at the end when we had like the storyboard and everything, we were like, oh, what we had this. It was like we didn't notice what we were doing until the end. Yeah, I hope it was okay.
So how was it to come back to the story after like a number of years, right? Because this was like fine arts, and then you came here, and
yeah,
and then you took it again. Yeah.
Yeah. It was great because maybe you also you guys happened that sometimes that you had an idea, you wrote it, and then that stays apart like for many years, and then you found it and you say, oh, that was me, nah? And it was like that feeling that, oh, okay, that's a nice story. I don't want to leave it like in this Schubladen, no? And yeah, that's why we were like also wanting to do a new short film. These guys, Jung and Shin, were not there. They were working in learning, doing mapping, and I was here. They were like,
yeah,
okay.
They were in France.
So they don't appear in the credits, but yeah, emotionally.
So you did mostly all the animation?
Yeah, with the help, of course, of Hojin, also a student here, and of
Sebastian.
Sebastian made the compositing. He's an amazing compositor.
Compositing artist.
Compositor, and Anjin, also an KHM.
So yes. Again, like collaborators, people who are around us. So now we're gonna show a little bit of a project we're doing right now, which is a project that Jung started like, I don't know, 4 years ago. It developed, we started applying for funding, blah, blah, blah. So now we got it to make it. It's around workshops, it's in Kalk. It's about doing this garden of special plants for this neighborhood here in Cologne, which is called Kalk. So this is a VR project we have been doing. We're gonna present it, finish it next year. Also for next year, we're gonna do a new short film, which Diana is gonna direct with another friend here from AKHM, which is Alvaro Parrilla, which is a Spaniard. I am also doing like a documentary film, essay film mostly, with another alumni from KHM. Her name is Laurencia Genske. She's a documentary filmmaker. And yeah, we're going to do this essay, which has is based on photographs she took in Mexico and some animations. What else? We're also developing an animation series. Also, because we're not like the script writers, with a group of script writers from the KHM also. They're called Lagerfeuer. There are three also from around our year, maybe a year later from us, they came into the KHM. Yeah, so now we're gonna show this, and afterwards we're gonna show this micro mapping, which Shin did in Saint-Omer in France, also with the Rencontres Audiovisuels from Lille, and some air works we have done through the years. So, Jung.
Kann ich kurz erklären?
Ja, ja.
Über das? Aha. Ah, okay, das ist ein Projekt, heißt Der Garten der Erinnerung. Habt ihr schon das gesehen? Von Anfang an haben wir immer Interesse an Interkultur und dann über Ausländer, über Migration. Und dann, das ist auch ein, ja, man sagen, eine Serie davon, und dann, ja, wir wollten immer irgendwie die Geschichte von den Leuten hören und dann auch irgendwie besonders aus Ausland oder irgendwie verschiedene Immigrationshintergrund, und dann damit, ja, wir haben überlegt, könnten wir vielleicht eine Natur von den Leuten sammeln und dann von den verschiedenen Ländern. Und aber gibt es keine Weise, aber weiter haben wir gewartet und dann recherchiert, und dann da gibt es ein VR-Software, heißt Tiltbrush, gerade ist das Openbrush geworden, und dann damit konnten wir dieses Projekt anfangen. Ja, wir sind nicht viel oder hochtechnisch, sondern wir benutzen viel solche Applikationen für unser Projekt oder Workshop. Und dann damit haben wir schon über 100 Pflanzen durch Workshop von einem Jahr gesammelt. Und dann, ich zeige euch gleich irgendwie drei Pflanzen davon. Und dann die Ausstellung mit der Sammlung von Pflanzen, ihr kennt das, 21. März. 2023.
Genau, das machen wir mit dem Inhouse, mit dem Integrationshaus von Kalk. Das ist eine Zusammenarbeit mit Ihnen.
Baum heißt Akazie, und dann eigentlich das ist von mir, habe ich erst einmal für Workshop Teilnehmer das gezeichnet, und dann in Korea gibt es normalerweise viele Bäume auf dem Berg, aber nach dem Zivilkrieg in Korea gab es kaum Baum auf dem Berg, und dann wir haben viele Akazie-Baum oder solche wie starke Bäume importiert, und immer im Herbst ich rieche oder kann man immer Duft von dem Akazie riechen. Mhm. Und ja, die Teilnehmer können Pflanzen oder Bäume zeichnen und dann dazu irgendwie etwas kulturelles Sachen. Und dann, die machen ein Voice-Over und dann damit erklärt die Geschichte aus Heimat. Das ist von mir, und dann das ist auch ein Student.
Der Plan ist, dass wir am Ende eine 3D-Umgebung machen, in der wir die kalte Hauptstraße wieder aufbauen und die Bäume da irgendwie einen Garten in diese Straße bauen, in die kalte Hauptstraße. Sorry, I jumped from German to English.
Und dann, ja, das ist eigentlich kleine Pflanzen, Zimmerpflanzen zu Hause und dann, ja, die haben auch mit dem Fantasie zusammen durch es gezeichnet. Und dann da gibt es auch. Und dieser Workshop ist gerade schon fertig, keine mehr. Aber wenn wir weiter diese mit anderen Straßen diese Projekt weitermachen könnte, dann ja, wenn ihr Lust hättet, ich lade euch da. Ja. Und dann ja, gibt es Tüte und dann Bäume und dann
ja,
genau. Die 70%, die haben irgendwie Pilze gezeichnet. Irgendwo. Okay, da auch. Und dann letztes. Das ist ein Christmas-Version. Und dann habe ich das gerade in dem Korea in einer Ausstellung. Was cool ist, kann man diese VR-Projekt nicht nur in Köln, sondern auch in Korea weiter fern schaffen. Und dann ja, ich wollte hier kleine koreanische Garten in der Kalkhauptstraße schaffen. Deswegen ich habe da gefragt, ob ihr ja die Besucher von einer Ausstellung, ja, ob ihr ein Pflanzen zeichnen auf dieser Straße. Und dann ist das heute angefangen und dann deswegen jetzt Update. Du wirst nur ein kleines Pflanzen. Aber das wird später noch weiter, weiter, mehr und mehr. Okay, danke schön.
So now you're invited to watch AR and some mapping, and I don't know if you have questions.
Yes, so I mean you are a collective, so somehow all you're like getting money from like different like projects and like films or like, you know, whatever, like workshops. How do you manage, literally, how you maintain it financially, vamos, in running, yeah?
Good question.
This is, you know, the main thing. How do you survive? You
yeah, know? Well, there's like commercial projects we do, like, explainers for internet, or like we have also done animated segments for documentary films, for documentary series that are shown in like I don't know, like bigger channels. The last thing we did like this was a project we did for Spiegel TV. Spiegel TV did a miniseries of three chapters of true crime series about yeah, true crime story here in Germany in the 90s, I believe this was. I forget. And they did that then for RTL, for the platform of RTL, which is TV Now. So. That we did also with a dear friend. She's called Anna Mahendra. She studied also with us. Ah, there's Anna. She came to us with the project because it was offered to her, but it was like a lot of, I don't know, like 15 minutes, and we had it has to be done like in 3 months. So she approached us because it is too much, was too big for her alone to do, and. Yeah, that's the last thing we did, like for TV, like for like a streaming platform. Then we do like funded projects.
But what I mean is like, you know, a project comes, so there is a percentage of the project, 10, 20, 50, that is like just to run the studio, and
then of course,
that's there is like, and then
there's also always like a cap on
exactly.
The if we do like even something small, there's always like a percentage that goes directly to the sustaining of the studio. Yeah, like in everything we do, even if we do like funded films, there's always like a percentage that goes to the studio. That's the way we have been doing it till now. Let's see if we can still make it like that.
And then you are like freelancers, right?
Like yeah, we're also like freelancers. Jung works sometimes here at the KHM. Diana does a lot of workshops for kids with an institution called Jugendkunstschule. Shin does a lot of also like compositing, also for TV, like short animations for, I forget the production studio. He also does some advanced After Effects workshops. I sometimes do like sound for films, for like documentary films, or edit also stuff. Because I have like this film school background. And that's about it. So it's a little bit of everything. So that's it. No more questions? Cool. Then come over.
Thank you. Thank you.